Welcome back! My name is BallerScuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1985. Today, we're going to talk about Theater Europe. The story of Theater Europe takes us to Personal Software Services. Personal Software Services is a British software company founded in 1981 by Gary Mays and Richard Cockayne. Personal Software Services released games for British computers starting in 1983. Initially, these were often clones of older arcade titles. In 1984, at the suggestion of designer Alan Steele, the company began releasing the Strategic Wargames series. These games would, as the name suggests, be wargame strategy games, typically based on World War II battles. The most recognizable of the early games in the series is perhaps The Battle for Midway, released in 1984. The game, however, did not do well and was seen negatively by critics at the time. Theater Europe is the fifth game in the Strategic Wargames series. It was designed by Alan Steele, Sean Pierce, and David Bolton. In the game, the player takes over a fictional conflict between NATO and the allies of the Warsaw Pact, with the player being able to choose either side. The game takes place over 30 days, in which the player's goal is to conquer Europe, forcing their opponent to surrender. There are three difficulty levels for the game. On level 1, the enemy will not use nuclear weapons unless provoked. On levels 2 and 3, the enemy will use nuclear and chemical attacks as it feels necessary. The player will be able to control their troops on the map of Europe. When a battle between troops happens, there will be a minigame where the player can shoot down enemy units for a combat bonus. After the battle, the player will have a chance to rebuild their units with given supplies. If the player wishes to request a chemical attack against their enemy, the player may have a chance to choose a capital city to target, and then will be told of the outcome. If the player wishes to launch a nuclear attack, the player will have to call a dedicated telephone number and get a special authorization code from an automated message. That authorization code is Midnight Sun. The player will then have the option to either postpone the launch, target a single city, or do a fire plan, which is a full-scale nuclear strike across Europe, ending the game in a nuclear holocaust. Personal Software Services released Theater Europe for British computers in 1985. That is a brief backstory to Theater Europe. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in, let's call it the game. This is Theater Europe. Now, this version of the game that I have is kind of a fan-modified version of the game. It is the original version, but they have included the documents that came with the game in kind of an introduction here. We'll briefly go through this. It's a lot of technical information in this one in terms of what everything does, and a lot of it is very dryly written. So we'll just kind of briefly go through this. There's a lot here. This program is dedicated to the people of the world in the hope that the game is never played for real. Allen and Friends, March 1985. Introduction. Many computer games of the arcade variety can be played by simply loading the program and getting hold of the joystick. Any rules, etc., can be picked up as you go along. This is not a game of this type. Do not take this to mean that this is a game of vast complexity. It is not that either. However, it is a game you will learn and enjoy far quicker if you follow the instructions. You must at least read these documents to understand the game. This game covers the first 30 days of the next war in Europe. You can choose to be the Supreme Commander of NATO or the Warsaw Pact. In your control are air and ground units. These are backed up by your ability to make strategic nuclear and chemical attacks. As the Warsaw Pact Commander, your task is to break the NATO alliance, which you see as a powerful invasion force poised on your border. You will achieve your aims by taking over West Germany. As NATO commander, your task is to stop any further Russian invasion of Europe. You'll achieve this by preventing the occupation of West Germany. So basically, Warsaw Pact is on the offense, NATO is on defense. All right, so then we kind of get into how all the phases work, how all the buttons work, what everything means. Like I said, it's a lot of information. I will point out that action screens are optional. You don't have to do them. We'll see how I do in them. We might turn them off on a second playthrough. We're going to at least play one of each army, so we'll go through. Map attacks, how you rebuild your unit, what your reinforcement schedule is. I will not have this memorized by any means. I'm just going to kind of wing it when it comes to that. Then we have the air phase and all the things that you can do with your air missions. Air superiority is going to be your main one. Counter air to try to get air superiority. Interdiction to cut off enemy resupplies and reinforcements. Reconnaissance to try to get a gauge on the army levels. Then we have special missions, which are basically chemical and nuclear attacks. We're not going to do any of those if we can help it, at least on our serious playthroughs. We might do a couple just let's see what happened playthroughs after that. This is all the stuff you can do with nukes. This is what happens when nukes happen. Then your opponent gets their turn. Some basic tactics, how to save, quit, and load. The advanced game, which is levels 2 and 3. And for whatever reason, they say the Warsaw Pact, but I believe that the Warsaw Pact is the easier of the two. We'll figure it out as we go along. But maybe I'm wrong and I'll do better with NATO this time. There's also some other air missions that you can do on the higher levels. Assault Breaker will attack ground units. The Warsaw Pact has some unique army units. The amphibious army, very useful. The airborne army, not so much. Neither is really resupplied, which is why they're kind of limited. But the amphibious army, like, you can take over a good spot there. Then more air phase missions. You can do a deep strike, which might be retaliated with a nuclear attack. You can do an iron snake, which will take out the railway network. Deep strike is basically just going in and trying to take out reinforcements deep in their territory. Special moves, it talks about the reflex system. Reflex system is a nuclear response to either chemical or nuclear attacks. So that's fun. And it's either automatic. You can turn it on and off, but luckily it'll normally be off. Advanced tactics, and then there's some neutral units. The Swiss, Austrians, and Yugoslavians are all neutral. NATO units is a lot of Western Europe. You have the Danish, the Dutch, the Belgians, the British, the West Germans, the Americans, the French, the Italians. Nobody from the Iberian Peninsula, but that's all right. We should be good with these, and hopefully we'll never have to officially ever use them. Warsaw Pact units, mostly Soviets, Russians, however you want to phrase it, but also Polish and Romanians, which they put as Romanians, which I've never seen before. Bibliography. He did a lot of work, Alan Steele did, to try to get these numbers accurate, to try to make the tactics accurate and all that kind of stuff, so... here's the bibliography of his sources, where he pulled the data. As you can see, a lot of these came from official government sources, which may or may not be true, but let's go with that they are. Right? Everybody kind of has their own idea of what the government says versus what is real and what the government actually does compared to what the government should be doing. Anyway, credits. Alan Steele, Ian Bird, David Dunn, PSS. We have talked about those. Whilst the producers of Theater Europe have taken every care in researching this program to ensure the accuracy of details, we must stress that the events depicted in this conflict simulation are entirely fictitious. They must never be allowed to happen. The danger is that they might. And then the version that I'm playing credits are below that. Thank you for that. All right, so those are the documents. Let's try to get into the game. And we'll do what we can here. I believe I do have the joystick plugged in properly. I haven't had too much of a chance to play this the way that I would like, but here we are in Theater Europe. It's not too bad. I read it all the way through. I did one take where I just read the whole documents. It took a half hour, so. So I'm like, we'll skip that. All right, let's do a Warsaw Pact to start. I feel that they are easier. It's the more standard way I think that people are going to want to play. Let's do Warsaw Pact. And then game level 1. We're just going to do game level 1. We'll turn on action screens for now. Let's play. All right. Movement phase. Warsaw Pact is ready. Is this my amphibious unit? That is. So let's fire them and move them over. That's as far as they can go. Okay, so the goal is, as you might pay attention here, you have some troops over here. My amphibious unit, they're going to go for Copenhagen here. West Germany is pretty stocked at the top, 7, but as soon as you kind of get down here, it's a little bit easier to attack. So we have 4, 3, 3, that's Bonn. That is our main goal, to be honest. We're going to go for Bonn, and then a 7 there. And then, there's a 2 there, but they're backed up by the Americans, which are the strongest that they can get. 9 is as tough as you're going to get. So our main goal is try to break through kind of northwestern Germany and then hopefully make it all the way into The Hague and Brussels. We might go after the French a little bit, but our main goal is really to get to Bonn. And if we can push a little bit further after that, that would be great, but who knows? Okay, move there. Move there. We're just gonna move all these guys forward for now. And try to get everything set up as best as we can, kind of up there. And then you there, you there, you there. Trying to move everybody, right? We're kind of going all in on these guys. You want to avoid the mountains. Mountains are bad. Don't want to deal with the Yugoslavians down there. And then the Italians here, like they're pretty weak, granted. But you don't really want to go after them. Oh, that is the... That is my airborne army, right? I don't want to move my airborne army just yet. You can only move them once in the air. So you saw they can move a ton. But once you move them and they land, that's pretty much it. They're just ground forces after that. And as you can see, they're not the strongest, right? They only have a 3. And there's not really anybody here I would really want to go for. Okay. Let's move on to the attack phase. All right. Now you can't do anything from there, so they can only attack on land. No attacking from you. Attack you. Attack you. There we go. Why wouldn't they let me attack before? Okay. And no. There we go. All right, so that's pretty much what I can do this first turn. Let's go ahead and stop there. Select battle. Which one's the most important one here? I think this top one is. So I'm gonna select this battle. Everything in the air needs to be destroyed. All right. Get him. All right. You don't want to fire kind of willy-nilly with the missiles, but you do want to try to get everything. Okay, you want to go after the far ones. Come on. Get them. Okay. They're gone, and... Got a helicopter out there. All right. Trying to get them. There we go. I feel like I'm hitting them, but it's not really doing what I want. Okay. Warsaw Pact rebuild phase. Okay, so what do we got here? 2. They're down to 5 from 7. They're down to 2. We wiped them out. West Germany's down. We haven't dealt with them. I'm going to try to avoid the Americans if I can, but yeah, I attacked here when I shouldn't have. Okay. Let's reinforce here. Yeah, that's the main one. That's what I want to do. I only had the one, so that's what we're going to do. Okay. Air. We want to push here, here, and here is my goal. Okay, so that's my air rebuilding. And supplies. We're going to need this. These two. Okay. So then air missions. So if it's yellow, that means we're tied with the enemy. If it's green, then we have more there than the enemy. And if it's red, we have less. So let me look up what my basic strategy is here for the air war. You want to put a lot into air superiority. I think we'll put that up to 30. That should be fine. Let's do a few counter air. And then we'll match those two. And then we will put the rest into air superiority. Okay. Nobody to reserve. No, thank you. Not at this time. Maybe later. Okay, there goes NATO, and we're under attack. We're rebuilding. Okay, we got more movement to happen. Really wish that you guys could move faster. You're amphibious, after all. Let's move you over there. Over there. Over there. And over there. Okay. Don't want to move you yet. Let's get you in there. I know that that's kind of risky putting him in there, but I think it'll work out for the best. Okay. We do want to go after that French Corps, just to give me a little bit extra movement, but ultimately my goal's up here. Okay. Attack phase. Take them out. Take them out. There we go. And then you. And you. And we will leave that core alone this time. All right. Like I said, my goal is kind of breakthrough upper Western Germany here. All right. Select the battle. We'll do this one. Yeah, we'll do this one. It's the more important one. And it seemingly went well last time, so we will try it again. Like, hit him! Like, I'm right on top of them. They even had directions on how to do this, and I'm following them very well. Alright, like, do I move it around the enemy? Like, right on top of you, my buddy. Alright. Oh, I feel like they got away with it. But yeah, the ones on the road are supposed to be mine. Which is why I'm not hitting them. Okay. Come on now. I feel like I'm missing something here. It's just not responsive the way that it was claimed in the manual. Okay, how'd we do? I thought so. All right. Rebuild the army will be here. Here. Those are good. Air. We will do here and here. Once again, we're kind of going for air superiority. Supplies. Oh, I need quite a bit here. We'll do that. That seems good to me. Okay. Everything looks good here to me. I don't see any reason to change it. No, thank you. All right, we got him on retreat. That's what we want to see. That is good. All right, so once again, we got you kind of just moving over there. We got you pushing, you pushing, you pushing, you pushing. Everybody just push. All right, we got, yeah, we broke through pretty well here. We should be able to take out the West Germans and the Dutch pretty soon. Those West Germans, though, are going to be a little bit more difficult. And once again, do not want to engage that U.S. army there. Maybe next time we'll have them move up. Or that one there. Let's have you go up there. We're just kind of, you know, playing a little bit of defense, but not a lot. And we'll have Romanians come up here. There's a lot more countries in Europe than are on this map, at least now. Yeah, that's a couple, that's a couple, that's a few. I think it's time for me to move my air army. Oh, they already said I moved them. That's not nice. All right, fair enough, I guess. Okay, we're going to have you. You attack you. You go for you. We're going to have you. Come on. You attack these guys, and you attack those guys. We're going to leave that army alone. And that army alone. I don't see a point in taking out them. That, yeah, we're trying to focus here. So we might be able to break through that line pretty soon here. Select battle. I'm good. I don't want to play those action sequences anymore. Okay, resupplies. We'll go with you. Yeah, that seems good. They're just kind of defense, but I think we're pushing pretty well here. Rebuild the air. Put it here. And supplies. Don't want anybody at one or two. So we'll keep resupplying as necessary. And then you're going to be important. So we'll have you do that. Okay. Everything looks good there. I don't see a reason to change it. You notice I don't have any reserves. The Warsaw Pact doesn't get a lot of air. Okay, let's, we're not doing that at all this game. Okay, NATO's backing off. That's what I like to see. Attacking? Nope. Rebuild phase. Okay, Warsaw Pact movement. We're on day 7. Things are going pretty well, I think. Come on, attack them. Oh, we're doing movement. You know what? That's fine. Getting ahead of myself. I just wanted to attack. Okay. Because once again, we're trying to avoid fighting them. But we'll move you guys over. And try to get those Romanians in there. Not sure that's ever really going to happen, but we can try just moving everybody over there. I was told that the amphibious army, like, they could do it on the first turn, but they wouldn't move from me. All right, pact attacked phase. You there. You attack them. You go there. And we'll have you attack them. You attack them, and you attack them. All right, so we're attacking a little bit harder now. And then once again, just ignoring the Americans down there. They're just too strong. Okay, let's go. No, thank you. Okay, rebuild. We got one army. We'll put it there. That seems like a good spot. No air this time. Supplies. One there. We'll try that. Okay, let's go. NATO's backing off. Oh, we got an attack. No thanks. All right, we got a rebuild phase going. Let's move again. Yeah, I've been told that, like, you can get the army all the way there on the first turn. Didn't see it happen, though. Okay. Come on, Polish guys. Everybody move into position for me. I'd be wondering, aren't you worried about resupplies? I should be. But, you know, I can only do so much. Move you there. Let's get you in the fight. Okay. We're still pushing. Like, the goal is to go kind of quickly here. Four and four. Let's have... I really want to wipe this out, if I can. And, yeah, you're the West Germans, so we'll have you go. And that's the Americans that I am avoiding. Come on now. Like, sometimes it just doesn't want to accept my button inputs. That's when it flashes like that. All right, we got a lot of people attacking. Let's go for it. I don't want to do those anymore. Okay, we got two armies in resupply. We'll put one there and there. Two air. There and there sounds good. Seven resupply, that's what you like to see. Once again, I'm just kind of winging it. Just kind of going as quickly as I can. There we go. I guess that'll do it. I don't have reconnaissance, and they put some in assault breaker. I'm going to keep it as is. I like that setup. All right. Backing off. All right, they're attacking. Go for it. Now rebuilding. Okay. What do we got? Day 11. I mean, we're making significant progress here. Question is, can I do it in time? We need you over here. You over here. You over here. We're fully in the Netherlands now. Let's move you down here. Try to get a surround going. I think that's the most I can really move that. Okay. You up here. You can kind of go in there, but really trying to go that way. And then there's good. Okay. Attacks. There. There. Come on. You up there as well. Take that down. Come on. There we go. And that is a lot on that one German corps. So hopefully that works out for me. I think we're good. No battle. Okay. I lost an army, but that's okay. They've lost so many. And rebuild my air here and here. Supplies. I think I got enough for all the ones here. That's about it. Okay. And now they're doing a deep strike. That's not nice. Okay. NATO backing off. They got a couple attacks going. NATO rebuild. And we have won! The NATO army has been defeated. Peace talks are underway. I have a command ability of 97%. That is insanely high. I didn't even take over Copenhagen like I wanted. I think the guy that I said that I was looking at was, they said the max you could get was 96, so they were wrong. I got a 97, apparently. Alright, so I have won. That's one round down of Theater Europe, and we got more to go, right? I want to show off going from the NATO side. I want to show off some of the things at the higher level, like the chemical and the nuclear strikes, but there we go. We basically took over Bonn and took over a lot of the Netherlands, and we're making progress into Belgium, so they kind of just gave me the victory. I'm not entirely sure what actually gives you the victory, but that is one aspect of Theater Europe played, and that is going to do it today for Theater Europe. I've been BallerScuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. I hope you laughed, I hope you learned, and I hope to see you next time for more Theater Europe. Thanks for watching.